So, you see people using this color ramp thing all the time, but you're not really sure how it works. Not a problem. In the next 2 minutes, you'll know exactly how this beautiful beast does its job. Alright, let's do this. Drag in your texture, drag color into base color, press Shift A, S, color ramp, and drag it over to existing connection. So, here's how this works. See this bar? Like all good things, it goes from 0 to 1. Everything on the left side represents all the darkest parts of your picture. So things like her shorts, her heels, her bra, her shirt, and hair will be affected by the left side of the bar. Everything on the right side represents all the lightest parts of your picture. So things like her skin, her hat, her boobs, and the background will be affected by what you do on the right side. Now, it'll always start off going from black to white. But look what happens if we click on the black point and change the color to red. See that? Before, we were telling Blender, make the darkest parts of the map black. But now we're telling Blender, make the darkest parts of the map red. And that's exactly what's going on. Now, if you click on the plus, it'll add another point to the bar. And if we change it to black, you'll see this. Now, you might be totally confused as to what's going on, but just relax. I promise it'll all make sense in a second. Look what happens if we grab the black point in the middle and move it far to the left. See that? These two points are telling Blender the very darkest parts of the map should transition from red to black. But these two points are telling Blender anything that's brighter should transition from black to white. So what if we wanted a Mario color scheme? What if we wanted the gray parts of the map to be blue instead? Well, if you add another point, change it to blue, now you can see that Blender still transitions the darkest parts of the map from red to black, but now it transitions the middle tones of the map from black to blue. And it transitions the lightest parts of the map from blue to white. Pretty cool, right? Now watch what happens when we move the white node closer to blue. And what you need to notice here is that the closer you drag two colors together, the sharper the contrast between those two colors. The farther away two colors are, the softer and more transition there will be between those two colors instead. And that's it, you're done. But wait, there's more. That's right, I'm not done with you yet. If you tap that notification bell right now, I'll throw in another tutorial absolutely free. So, for those of you who are wondering what Blender's really doing behind the scenes, or if that last explanation wasn't clear enough for you, I've created this image to help you visualize the entire process. So here's what's actually happening. As soon as you drag in the color ramp, it changes your image to black and white. At that very moment, it also goes through each pixel in the picture and remembers which pixels were dark and which pixels were light. All the pixels that were black get a value of 0, and all the pixels that were white get a value of 1, and all the pixels that were shades of gray get a value somewhere in between. And so you can see what those values are, I've mapped each shade of gray out for you on the top. As I've told you before, Blender thinks that black is 0 and white is 1. And it thinks this shade of gray is 0.5, it thinks dark gray is 0.25, and it thinks light gray is 0.75, so on and so forth. So if I add a red point here and move it to 0.7, here's what Blender is actually doing. Blender sees this red point at 0.7 and decides all the pixels that have values from 0.7 to 0 are gonna transition from red to black. And all the pixels that have a value from 0.7 to 1 will transition from red to white. If I add another value and make it blue at 0.3, now Blender is saying all the pixels with the value from 0 to 0.3 will transition from black to blue. And all the pixels with the value from 0.3 to 0.7 will transition from blue to red. And that is what's actually going through Blender's mind when you move these points and colors. So there you have it, two different ways to understand one of the most important aspects in Blender. Anyway, hope that helped. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Hope you have a fantastic day, and I'll see you around.